Hello, it is July 20th, and it looks like, well, we had a big storm last night. It's really windy here in West Michigan, and it looks like I see a downed tree branch over in the in-ground garden. Off from that tree right there. Well, let's go have a look. This happened last year. I had a big branch fall down into the garden, and it took out a lot of my trombone squash and some of my butternut squash, and it was just heartbreaking. Yep, there's a big branch. There's a big branch that fell down. Darn it. Oh, Mr. Owl's down. Oh yeah, you know what though, it looks like it's up on the two fences here. Oh, I hope so. So this is the pumpkin patch along with some squash, and I don't want to lose anything like I did last year. I know, it's what you get for planting a garden under a maple tree, but this is the best sun in the yard. So, oh, let's see. Sorry there, Mr. Owl, we'll fix you up later. Okay. Oh, doesn't look like anything's damaged. All right, good news. Last year I lost a bunch of stuff, a bunch of squash. Where'd it come from? Oh, right up there, somewhere. Big winds last night. We currently don't have any power. But you know, that happens every now and then. They'll have it back on here directly, I would imagine. But the pumpkin garden, pumpkin patch is doing really well. We've got some little pumpkins starting to form. Everything's starting to spread out real nice. So this is doing well. Oh, and I've got the trombone squash growing up this trellis here. So that's gonna make its way up there in a couple weeks. Let's go check out the raised bed garden here. Let's start on this side. Peppers. Pepper container. We've got some peppers. They keep getting bigger and bigger every day, of course. Those compared to these peppers I put in the tomatoes. We got some peppers on here, but you know, like I said before, I'll never plant peppers with tomatoes again. They're just puny compared to the other ones. Yellow squash. Starting to produce. Green bean flowers are starting to really come on. Here's a couple of green beans. Cucumbers are starting to climb up the trellis finally. So that's good. Happy about that. Kales are still doing fantastic. Not many caterpillars or worms or any insects that much this year, except for we do have the beetles attacking the sunflower. Look at that. But you know, We'll see if we can't get that taken care of. I harvested my first zucchini yesterday, and it was wonderful. Made a nice stir fry out of it. There's another one down there. The wind really turned this bed, or this zucchini around. It'll come back. The Beauregard sweet potatoes are doing fantastic. Yeah, they're doing real good here in the straw bed and in the raised bed. The vines are starting to go crazy. This is one of the vines right here. They're just going all over the place. That's going to be fun trying to control them. Got another zucchini down here, young plants. Acorn squash, I believe I saw a female down in here somewhere. There it is. There it is. My wife's gonna be happy about that. It's her favorite. Oh, all the melons are climbing up the fence nicely. We got a sugar baby down in here somewhere. Oh, there it is. So that's getting big. I got some cantaloupe and a honeydew in there as well. Okra is starting to produce nicely. There we go. Let's see if we can find some. There we go. Yeah, we got some okra in there. And some red. The red okra starting to come on. Well, this is the other side of the peppers. Yeah, we got peppers coming, jalapeno. What's this, Jimmy Nardello? Chili. I got Tabasco in there too. I haven't seen anything from those yet. Here's that onion that I just think is starting to go to seed. It's just beautiful, I love that. Okay, what do we got here? We've got the cherry tomatoes. They're doing fantastically. We got us some cherry tomatoes. And it's, you know, it's all throughout. As you go up and up and up, I just keep forming. Right now this, I'm single stemming. Right now this cherry tomato is height wise, it's close to 6 foot. These stakes are about 8 feet. And it's about 6 foot. So it's getting up there and they're all doing well. They're all doing well. Oh yeah, cherry tomatoes everywhere. They'll be turning red here and ripe pretty darn soon, I would imagine. And over here we've got some carrots, a couple basil plants, another sunflower, and these are the steak tomatoes on the cattle panel trellis cage. They're doing really good. Got tomatoes throughout. Loving it. Nothing ripe yet, but you know that's coming. But this trellis is wonderful. I love this tomato cage. You see, I can just put some sticks through there and I tie them down just in case the tomato wants to go this way. And usually the branches will just stick through the cage. But every now and then I'll grab a stick out of the yard and I'll just put them through just for some little extra support for these guys. But I highly recommend this way of packaging up your tomatoes, your steak tomatoes. All right, the old strawberry bed. We got zucchini, and then some pickling cucumbers in the middle, and they're starting to take off. I'm probably gonna have to trellis these pickling cucumbers up shortly. All right, so this garden is doing well. The green beans are starting to fill in the trellis. The leaf lettuce is doing well still. Spinach has gone to bolt, you know, but that's good. And the cut and come again lettuce is starting to come again. So that really works. I like that. The ground cherries. Starting to get a lot of those. Tomatillos. Tomatillos are doing well. Everything's looking really well. Like I said, the cucumbers are starting to go up the fence and the trellis there. We got a late start with those, but we're still gonna get a really good harvest, I would imagine. And the ground cherries on this side are producing like crazy. It's actually going up this trellis as well. So that's fun. First time growing the tomatillos and ground cherries this year. Let's go look at the peppers real quick. On the other side of the fence here, all the carrots. Carrots, we've been harvesting a couple here and there for the kids. A couple in there that they can harvest later. Oh, they love them. Let me see, peppers. There's some Jimmy Nardellos in there. We got some chili over here. Everything's really starting to produce pretty good. Got some jalapeno. I think this is a Tabasco, which must be a late bloomer. I don't know, we've got some bell. Where are you, bell? There we go, we got three or four of them in there. So I'm really liking this bed this year. And this jalapeno, this is actually two jalapeno plants. Oh, there's a little one. So they're coming on, but they're not coming on as quickly as this one jalapeno. So that was an experiment this year. You know, putting two jalapeno peppers in together compared to just the one. And the one is producing faster. So, cucamelons. See the cucamelons? They're coming on up this trellis here quite nicely. So that's a first this year. I'm happy about that. All right. What else do we have to show you? I've got some morning glories coming up the fence line over here, or the fence. I built this little trellis out of some sticks. And on this side, I've got, I think it's trombone squash and some morning glories. And they're growing like crazy. They're just coming on up. Oh, look, and some sweet potato vine. This is 5 feet right here, and I've got a sweet potato vine right here. That's crazy. Trombone squash, and oh, look at that guy. Look at him. Morning glories. Nice. And we've got some more peppers out here in the straw. Second year straw bale. Jalapenos. This must be the Tabasco. Nothing on there yet. Oh no, this is the Bell. This is the Tabasco. Nothing. Chili peppers. What do we got here? Jalapeno? Yep, jalapeno. Jimmy Nordello. I am happy with the second year. There's some Bell. The second year straw bale for pepper plants. Doing really, really well. Oh, and I harvested my first trombone squash yesterday with the grandkids. It was huge. Now we've got some more coming on. There, there, they're everywhere. So that's gonna be fun. But anyways, we had a nice big storm, windstorm last night. I don't have any power right now. Fun. Living the life. Catastrophe in the garden. There it is. Check out last year's Catastrophe in the Garden video that I did. This is minor compared to last year's. Last year's is just, oh my Lord. Oh my Lord, it was something else. Anywho, there you go, quick little garden tour. I got some cleanup to do. Hey, I hope you all have a wonderful day. It's a great day to be a gardener, even when you have to clear out brush from your garden. All right, y'all take care. We'll see you.